That's Leo's entire role, pretty much.
That's against the rules.
Break the rules!
Okay, I'll do it.
What a sad existence for Leo. He basically runs around saving people all day and getting constantly interrupted by the harpy shrieks of the charmed ones. Leo! Leo! Leo!
I don't understand where her sisters...
And the most important people in the universe!
And they lived happily ever after.
Yeah, right.
Right.
She's doomed to be forever alone, just like us.
I will not falsify evidence. I'm a cop.
Whatever, Daryl. You stick to the background until we run out of characters again. This was the obvious course for Piper to take due to her motherly nature. I freaking love babies.
I still think magic is a gift. But Grams gave us the greatest gift of all. A normal childhood. The gift of innocence.
Unlike the suckers we're gonna have, fuck 'em. They need their innocence crushed. I'm so glad I forget this episode's lesson later on. This is his lot in life, or the afterlife as they confusingly refer to it. Leo, get me some fuzzy slippers. We're watching Oprah today. And don't give me any of that I have to save innocence crap.
Can you do that in public?
Leo, I will destroy you.
And wait, if Leo needs to eat, does he need to shit too? Or does he just leave his waste behind when he orbs away?
Leo, don't leave your shit lying around the house!
It wasn't me, it was a page.
Don't you fucking lie to me! I know the difference between all-white lighter and half-white lighter shits!
Leo, we don't stand a chance against him.
And we're more important, mainly me!
I don't think a witch is allowed to marry a demon. Honey, we can't have a demon in the family.
Only I can have a marriage that endangers us all. Don't be selfish, Phoebe.
What happened?
Where have you been?
I left slutting it up at the office party for this.
I owe him more than that.
An express ticket to hell.
Leo gets his paternity leave to spend more time with his family, and as soon as this marriage counselor thing comes up, Piper accuses him of being codependent. What do you want, woman?
Why can't you be around all the time to hear me bitch, Leo? Leo, it's like you never leave me alone.
Leo wants Piper to be careful during the pregnancy, especially since her mother died so young. Apparently, pregnancy makes you criminally insane?
Shut up, Leo. You don't tell me what to do. I'm gonna cast a bravery spell so I can be reckless.
She's also gonna teach us how to be your midwives.
Midwives? No.
Your body, your choice, our asses.
I think my baby is trying to turn me into some kind of pacifist.
Huh. What does Leo say about this?
Well, mostly Leo says, sorry, honey, I gotta go.
Stupid Leo, focusing on helping innocents instead of preventing me from becoming a pacifist. Doesn't he know this is the worst thing that could ever happen to me?
All that for a guy? Boy, did you get taken for a ride.
Unlike me, I only chose to be the queen of all evil for a guy.
Demon activity has been light, so it's a good time to get ahead.
Speaking of ahead, I can't believe you guys didn't notice my billboards downtown.
Who cares about the baby? You aren't reassuring me on how awesome being famous is.
Protecting an elder from demons is safer than working at a club?
Oh wait, Cole wants to talk? Suddenly I have all the time in the world!
But I just have to concentrate on me right now. You know, and not be afraid that I may never find love again.
I can't worry about that guy's death. There hasn't been enough focus on me lately.
Paige, please just turn off the phone.
Only my problems are worth putting evil stopping on hold.
Well, maybe if you put your head underwater and get my hair wet?
That innocent can rot in hell with Cole.
You evil bastard, why didn't you just stay where you belong?
In hell.
You whore! You filthy whore!
You could at least, like, tell him you're breaking up with him.
Yeah, whatever. I'll tell him when he burns in hell with Cole.
Damn it, I wish I never existed!
They keep screwing him on his cases this season. Poor Daryl.
Whatever, Daryl.
Oh, man.
She ends up staying behind to live with the Valkyries because she can't handle her feelings toward Leo.
Haha! Good luck with everything, Wyatt!
I just think that we have to face the reality that Chris's destiny might have been just to come here and warn us about Wyatt. And that's all.
Get over it, Chris. You're only being written out of existence. What's the big deal, Cole? It's just hell. Some people just can't get over themselves.
He's presenting proof that a person in her house is a murderer, and she's whining about other stuff and ignoring him.
Shut up, Leo. Who hasn't murdered someone in this house?
I have half a mind to call Jason and complain about it, but I don't want to use our relationship for leverage.
What's the use of sleeping with your boss, then?
Heh heh heh. Men are only there to be used and thrown away.
But he's my innocent.
Yeah, but this is our problem, and one we did not ask for, by the way.
So what if he sold his soul and is going to rot in hell? Think about how this inconveniences us, Paige.
Yeah, I think we need to talk to Paige first.
Because this little power one kick of hers is getting out of control. Look, I'm not saying that we need to gang up on her, but this is clearly becoming a pattern, and we need to remind her that we have a shared destiny to worry about, too.
Since when did saving innocence have anything to do with our shared destiny? This is all about us!
It's repetitious to hear someone telling them, hey, there's a demon, and they're like,
whatever, dates!
I could sum up every episode with,
well, we can't figure it out right now, so I'll be at work.
She uses this as an excuse to give unwanted advice to everyone, and inflate her ego even more. She's like waiting around the corner to tell someone what they should do with their life.
Hey y'all, it's Phoebe. Want some advice? Wait, where you going? Got some advice for ya!
Yeah, it's still a lot to give up.
What I get from him is kind of more than makes up for it, I think.
Ew.
Ew, relationships are icky. I'm the world's greatest advice columnist.
I'm interested in dedicating a month of my column to the protection of our children, and I was sort of wondering, you know, if something, God forbid, were to happen to my nephew Wyatt, what do you think the police might do to try to figure out who did it?
That sounds like the most suspicious question in the world, Phoebe.
Theoretically, if I were to murder a baby, how long would it take for them to find the sack in the river before I skip town?
Like, he's very adamant about not being involved with this, but they just go,
shut up, Daryl.
Oh, man.
Hey, Daryl, we made a man. Now get the fuck out of here so we can food fight.
I don't want to know. I don't want to know.
I love Daryl, and I know this is eating him up inside, but you girls are like family to us. You don't turn your back on family.
Good. We need to borrow Daryl's soul again.
What?
Piper is resistant because this involves people they know.
This isn't about me or my children. What the hell?
They didn't even tell her. They just appointed Leo headmaster behind her back. How did they even have that kind of authority? Like, imagine this scenario.
Hey, Phoebe, we decided you needed a career change, so the column is called Ask Leo now. What? We've already got everything switched over. Get out. No one does this to the great Phoebe one. Misogyny!
It's like when Superman just puts super in front of whatever power he has to make it sound better.
I've got Charmed One column writing powers.
Who do you think teaches me to be a white letter?
Me?
I know I spent half the season running a fucking school, but what? Teaching? Preposterous.
We can't bail them out. Heroes have to be heroes. I read a lot.
Yeah, I know you do. Maybe you should get out a little more.
Piper, you idiot. Heroes have to go to work all the time and get facials when danger is afoot. I'm sorry, I was possessed by a good person for the sake of a joke. Actually, I'm not sorry.
So maybe I should stop giving advice to people on finding love until I could figure out how to find it myself.
Or know the concept.
Love is celebrating two birthdays, right?
Phoebe doesn't like him because he's, dun-dun-dun, a man!
Men don't know about feelings or shit like that. Only I, the great Phoebe one, would know about it.
And you don't think a man can give advice to women?
No, actually not as well as a woman can, no.
It's impossible to understand the opposite gender, unless of course you're Phoebe.
Pretty damn good kisser. Even though it didn't mean anything.
He complimented me. Perhaps I'll let him live.
The only reason I took this gig is because I'm a huge fan of yours.
Yes, good. I feed on your meaningless praise.
But wait, dare he take calls from other women even though he and Phoebe are in no way in a relationship at this point, and in fact, Phoebe has gone out of her way to treat him like herpes-riddled cancer?
How dare he find someone sexy other than me? I'll eviscerate him!
Leslie wins a Reader's Choice Award for an article he ghostwrote for Phoebe. And she's all like,
yeah, I'm hot shit.
And he's like, yeah, I wrote that one. And then she doesn't know how to save face, and I laugh hysterically.
Yeah, sorry, Phoebe. Leslie was just so good at this. And he's got a penis. I'm tough but fair. Oh no, my nightmare has become reality.
Now that Phoebe has truly learned the meaning of love, she goes around calling herself Cupid and giving the other characters unasked for love advice. Barf. Could her ego possibly be any more inflated?
Just call me Cupid! Ha ha ha, men are only objects!
Once Piper comes back, she doesn't give Cole any credit or tell anyone else shit about it.
Thanks a lot, Cole. Now go burn in hell!
Pirates? Like hot Johnny Depp pirates?
If we acknowledge it's a ripoff, it's okay! Ha ha ha, alright, Johnny Depp turned us down.
Oh man, this family reunion sure got awkward.
Oh hi, honey. Ruling the world and killing millions of people yet?
Damage?
We've done more than almost anyone to protect your grand design.
So what if we stop people from dying? We're more important than you. You're just the angel of death. Leo, somehow this is your fault.
And in Piper's version, it's the direct opposite. You can't cheat death, unless you know about the list, in which case you can totally cheat death.
It's kill or be killed, I say.
He's so overcome with guilt, he's forgotten how to shower and has been covered with smudges from Piper's secret chocolate stash.
You know those were for my Sex in the City nights, Leo.
Uh-oh.
Hi. Could you please not do that around the children?
You should just let the demons try to kill us, idiot.
And why would they have to help him? They've blown off universe-destroying shit. You really gonna depend on these goons having any sense of self-preservation?
Yeah, we could stop you from exposing us, or I could watch supermarket sweeps.
I knew she should not have gotten him involved in this. This was a bad idea. I'm sure it's his fault.
Stupid testicle mongers with their article stealing and dreamer ways.
Hey, at least he's not calling him Kyle. You know what I mean?
I'll decide what you get to call people.
Yeah, see, breakfast is not a date.
Only I can go on breakfast dates.
But now that Leo isn't crazy and his life is back on track, Piper doesn't want to see him.
I only want the opposite of what he wants, okay?